expectations were to discover how Uganda is treating the subject of global citizenship education and what we can learn from them, and also to test some tools that we have at Annoncer la Couleur to see if they're working in the South also.
That both in Uganda and in Belgium we share a lot. Talk about gender inequality is in Uganda and also in Belgium. Talk about sexual harassment, what is in Uganda is happening in Belgium. It may happen in different ways, but really it is happening.
I was really happy about the subjects that Enable chose, meaning global citizenship. It's the perfect setting to do it, with this particular focus on gender, which I'm very interested in.
How do you feel? Ask yourself.
We shared to the extent of now teaching together. We went to class together and shared a lesson, taught together. And it gave me a lot of insight to know what happens.
C'est super enrichissant d'un point de vue enseignement, parce que j'apprends des choses que je pourrais transmettre aussi à mes étudiants, que d'un point de vue culture et façon de vivre.
On a pu se rendre compte des pratiques dans les classes, des émotions que les enseignants pouvaient avoir par rapport à ces pratiques. On a fait beaucoup d'analyses et alors on a mis en place de nouvelles pratiques, on a co-créé des dispositifs. Donc je crois que l'échange est très positif à ce point-là.
I've built a lesson with someone completely different from me, not only because he's a general method teacher and I'm not, but also because he's from such a different culture and background than me. And I really was scared about that. I really had doubt that it could be doable, especially on gender, because I had all my idea about what gender was in Uganda. And well, first of all, I was very surprised to learn about the situation here.
I feel transformed and I have a global outlook now. I like the way my students were inquiring and finding out issues that relates to their life in the concept we taught and how it relates to their visitor who came from Belgium. So in a way, that one we would want to go and also transfer to our institution where we have come from. I'm so grateful.
Donc on part d'un problème, on essaye de résoudre le problème, on met en groupe, on fait travailler les élèves, et ça, que ce soit en Ouganda ou en Belgique, c'est ce qui est attendu des professeurs, formateurs, d'enseignants.
I think this exchange project was just awesome. It really met the expectations. And in the beginning, I was also a bit anxious, like how will Belgian lecturers coming to Uganda for the first time react? I was afraid they would be overwhelmed by the differences they would see between the Belgian educational system and the Ugandan educational system. But actually, what I'm very proud of is that they did not focus on the differences, but they really focused on the similarities they have and what they can learn about similarities and how they can handle it.
I feel extremely delighted and very happy about this exchange, because it's going to improve on my knowledge of how to handle my students using active teaching and learning methods as well as techniques.
Ils sont sûrs d'eux, ils prennent des groupes de 50, 60 élèves et ils y vont, ils foncent, ils sont sûrs d'eux parce qu'ils ont eu le primaire, le secondaire, on n'a pas arrêté de les féliciter pour ce qu'ils disaient et on les félicite 10 fois par heure, mais c'est l'ensemble du groupe qui les félicite et ça je trouve ça extraordinaire.
I hope that this will change how they teach also, because they can really make the link and interconnections between Belgium, Uganda, but also with the bigger picture of the world, and seeing that it's not just a small problem, but it's really a more wide problem that has to be resolved. And yeah, I hope they'll go back to their pre-service teacher differently after this exchange.